Well, first of all, we all have hair and we all have been styling it. What we found though is us with curly, coily, and textured hair have often had a difficult time distinguishing which products are best for it. So we thought, let's use science to better understand and characterize the nuances of our hair so we can then better choose products for the future.
Well, over the last several years, we've been working on the use of origami as a simple way to make complex shape-shifting polymers. One thought came to our mind that is, wouldn't it be really nice if we can extend this technique to make origami inorganic shapes, which are really notoriously difficult to process into complex shapes because of their brittleness.
So this musical periodic table is a new audiovisual musical instrument that takes the concepts of chemical spectroscopy and communicates them in a really engaging way using sound effect that you see in like a cheesy horror movie sound effect. But they all have their own unique sound and collection of frequencies.
We are observing more and more very unique and exceptional fermented coffees that are now also becoming mainstream. And they are also being used in competition all over the place. And the real motivation of our work is to understand where these flavors are coming from. How are they generated chemically? What type of fermentation generate the compound? And what compounds are actually responsible for this unique and novel flavor that are really expanding the flavor world of coffee?
So we engineered mammalian cells to express large amounts of this protein reflected. That is also found in squid skin cells, such as tunable leucophores and some female squid. And we found that those reflectin proteins self-assembled structures that were very similar in many ways in terms of both their sizes and their optical properties to those found in the leucophores. And so that really allowed us to capture some of the properties of those squid skin cells in the mammalian cells.
So we found out that we could uncouple food intake from nausea and vomiting. That's actually really, really positive because they're all controlled by the same part of your brain. And as a consequence, we produced a drug that not only produces really profound weight loss, and we were reducing food intake in rodents by 87% over 2 days, which is really phenomenal. And we were doing this at doses 10 times that of current FDA medications without any observed nausea or vomiting.
So Narcan, the golden standard, it's actually really effective against overdoses for things like heroin. However, it has been shown to be ineffective against fentanyl class synthetic opioids. We have decided that, you know, with these synthetic opioids, they're not going anywhere, that we really need to investigate another mode of action or a better route to prevent these synthetic opioid overdose deaths.
There is this need to come up with a way that can do this without making needles, which are, they have blood on them, they're biohazardous, and they require a skilled person to inject, obviously, because you don't want an unskilled person just playing with needles. And this is super easy. You don't have to be particularly clever to operate it. You load it up and point it and then push the button, right? And then that's it, and then the person can leave.
So still we have only the prototype device, and using the prototype device, we were able to clean 1 liter of water contaminated with microplastics in less than 90 minutes.
So maybe at first we try to make a very smooth isocellulose layer, like the white layer. So then we tried to make some texture of the isocellulose layer. The film can be used for the some management for the building or cars. And I think they are vivid color should make them more compatible, like than the ones with the white or the mirror-like appearance.
Materials from outer space that are, you know, well over a billion years older than Earth. And we're getting this sneak peek back into the, you know, origins of the solar system. And we're able to take these materials, extract the organic matter that is soluble in our solvents, and analyze them and take a look at those complex matrices that basically exist out in space that never even thought would have been there.